Hi, my name is Rena, and I sell fresh cut manzanita on my Etsy shop, which is called Silent Bazaar. I just wanted to show the process of what I do when I get these manzanita, when I get the orders. I will not cut them until payment has been processed and is cleared. So here I have a fresh cut manzanita branch. This one's really big, but I'm going to go ahead and cut it down into a few smaller branch sizes and show you what I do. I use branch cutters because they do nice clean cuts. And because the manzanita branches are so dense and thick, this is the easiest way to get clean cuts. I'm going to have to cut this one down a whole lot more. I'm going to get a few cuts just to show you my packing process. And then I also have, while I'm doing this, I'm going to go ahead and go over some frequently asked questions. One of the biggest questions is how long will the leaves stay green for? I've just started selling these in December, so I'm not exactly sure how long the leaves will stay green for. And hopefully you can see in the videos, this is a fresh cut tree. And this branch, I had water in the container, and it's about 2 months old since it being cut, and you may be able to see the difference. Leaves will still come off during this whole process, but you can see the difference between, this is an older leaf off of a fresh cut. It still folds because they are brittle. And that one you can see has more of an easier rip to it, but they will last. Leaves will fall off. Rather, it's fresh. They'll fall off faster when it's dried out. As you can see, I've got leaves all over the table already. Let's get some of those off. So these branches, I'm going to put this one aside because I was just showing you how I cut them. I've already got some that are pre-cut. Before I package them, which this is ready to be packaged, wire cutters are a fantastic tool. So if you need to cut anything off with fresh cuts, and this is what I do when I process them. You can see there is some dead branches, dead areas where the seeds have fallen off. But I do clean up all the branches before I ship them out. So once all of these are ready to be packaged and they're all cleaned up, some more leaves, more berries, I upcycle some paper. These are paper bags. I work with kids, and these are from their lunches. They just throw them away, and they make a really good packing material for these branches. Now, with manzanita, they're extremely dense, like I said before, but they also are really flexible when they're fresh. So it is very easy for me to take these strings and tie them down to a smaller level. And the reason why I do this is for shipping purposes. Because they are heavy and long items, the shipping gets quite expensive. It has to go parcel through USPS, and you can see how flexible that is, where they're not even breaking. But the shipping is going to depend on the size of the package, the weight, and the location in which it's going. So let me get these tied down. See, I can squish all that and nothing's going to, maybe a few leaves may come off. But when you receive your order, the leaves, enough leaves are still going to be intact to where it's not going to matter. The leaves will stay attached, I would say indefinitely, as long as it doesn't get bumped around too much or shuffled. As soon as you get your package, what you should do is unwrap and untie it so that you can see the natural shape of the leaves. If you are doing a wedding or a birthday, I haven't really seen a difference upon keeping the leaves in water versus without water. The leaves stay green for pretty much the same time period. It's about a couple months. They will get lighter. They'll turn more of a mint color, obviously, because they're not in the ground. Once I get all of this packaged, see, here's the bag. I cut the bottoms off so they're easier. And then this one's a big puffy one. So don't be surprised if you get this package in the mail. Oops, that one came off. And there are some loose leaves at the bottom. That is perfectly normal. Also, when you do large orders, I normally will send some smaller clippings that I've clipped off that are still viable to act as filler. I typically won't do that with one order, I'll do that with more. So here we have a package, it's pretty low, it's pretty condensed. When I get multiple orders, which I normally do, I will take multiples and push them down and tape them to get them as small as possible for putting them in the box for shipping. All right, we'll see you guys later.